use the numeric entry object to enter data. On the touchscreen version of the Seymour Micro, you can touch the entry button, up pops a virtual keypad, you enter data, and say enter. The data has just been sent down here to the associated tag, which would normally be located on a PLC. This object is very similar to the numeric display object, so this video will only cover three additional features: function key assignment, range selection, and panel style. Check out the How to Use the Numeric Display video for tips on how to use all of the data display formatting options. Before we get started though, note that in the simulator, you can specify which bezel you're using with the Seymour Micro. I'm going to reduce the size of this to make room. And you click on this button right here to select the panel setup you have. This is the Seymour Micro by itself, or if I click this button, we add the arrow key bezel. Or if we click the button again, now we add the numeric keypad bezel. Or if we click it one more time, we just get the little LCD display all by itself. I'm going to click it one more time just to bring up the generic panel. These bezels are all optional add-ons you can get for your Seymour Micro depending on your application. The reason this is important is that data entry depends on the type of panel setup you have. This is best understood with a few examples, so let's take a look. Double-click or drag the numeric entry onto the screen. Note that if you see one formatted the way you like down here in the parts list, you can also drag that directly onto the screen too. Choose the bezel type here in the Object Style box. Object Style 1 is primarily for touch screens. Touching the numeric display or function key you assign activates the numeric entry box and brings up a virtual keypad to enter the data on the screen, like the one you saw a few moments ago. This is only good for touchscreens, of course. Let's try it real quick. Let's assign a function key. How about F1? We need to assign a tag to tell the Seymour Micro where to put the data. We use this set point tag here. And we need to select the object style, so we got object style 1. That looks good. Let's hit OK. Simulate it. Save the project. And up pops our simulator with our numeric entry object. Now if we click on the screen, we get our virtual keypad, we can enter the data, and now that data has been sent down to the tag, which is usually located on a PLC. Because we also assigned F1 to this numeric entry object, F1 will also bring up that numeric keypad. Clear the display, put different data in, and say go for it. Even though we have a touch screen here, this numeric entry method also works with the other keypad bezels. You would use the arrows to select the object, enter to bring up the keypad, and now you can use a virtual keypad or the numeric keypad to enter data. If you don't have a touch screen, then object style number 2 is going to be a better choice. Let's say OK, simulate it, save the project. With Object Style 2, you can still use the touch screen, but when you click on the object, instead of a virtual keypad, it brings up the function keys for entering data. Likewise, we could also have brought that up with function key F1 because that was still assigned. Using the function keys, you can use F2 to shift to the digit you want to modify, use F3 to increment it, F4 to decrement it, and 5 to accept it. This method also works with both the optional arrow and keypad bezels. Same thing. Use the arrows to select the object, enter to bring up the method, and now you can use either the function keys or the numeric keypad to enter the data. Let's look at the last object style number 3. This one assumes you have a keypad bezel installed. Let's see what happens. Say OK, simulate, save the project. And now we try it. If you have a touch screen, it'll still get the focus, but there's no way to enter the data except using the keypad bezel. Likewise, F1 is still assigned to this object, so that would get its focus, but still you have to use the keypad bezel to enter the data. So we have lots of ways to enter the data. Mostly it depends on your personal preference. The last unique feature of the numeric entry is the range. Here you can set the upper and the lower bounds of the data that you want the user to enter. Let's try it. We enable the range option, and for our example, let's put a minimum of 10 and a maximum of 90. Let's go back to object style 1 so we can use our touchscreen entry. Say OK, simulate, save the project, and here's our simulator. So let's try a couple examples. How about 99? Since we had an upper limit of 90, let's see how the CMOR Micro handles that. Oh, it gave us an error message. We entered a value that's above the high limit. Okay, let's clear that. And let's see, our lower limit was 10, so let's put a 9 in. Say enter. Now we got a low limit error. Let's clear that, and we'll put in a 50. We know that's in the middle. And say enter, and we finally get an acceptable value. This is a great way to prevent users from accidentally entering data out of range. Note that when we bring up the numeric entry dialog, we have to clear the data before entering new data. You can change the behavior to auto-clear that numeric entry. Check out the video on how to auto-clear numeric entry to learn more about that. Well, that's it for this video. Be sure to check out all the other videos in this series. And as always, please send us any topics you would like to see covered, or any other comments for that matter. We appreciate the feedback.